post-disaster nuclear safety endeavours. 2 months after the devastating March 11th earthquake and tsunami, in northeastern Japan, workers at the damaged power plant in Fukushima Prefecture continue their efforts to minimise the nuclear crisis. Thousands of residents who once lived within 20 kilometres of the facility are still banned from entry due to dangerously high levels of radiation, with many who remain in shelters. On Saturday, May 7th, Crown Prince Naruhito and Crown Princess Masako went for the second time to offer encouragement to evacuees forced to leave Hirono Town in Fukushima Prefecture. The government is meanwhile monitoring the radiation levels at schools in the affected area, with latest measurements showing that they continue to fluctuate. On Friday, after Prime Minister Naoto Kan asked Chubu Electric Power Company to suspend operations at its Hamaoka nuclear plant in central Japan due to the plant's location near a quake fault line, thousands of people marched through the streets of Tokyo in protest of nuclear power in Japan. Demonstrations were also held Sunday in central Japan near Chubu Electric Power Company's headquarters in Nagoya, where people called for the plant's shutdown as a step toward a nuclear-free society, despite a statement made by Deputy Chief Cabinet Secretary Yoshito Sengoku that same day that the nation would continue with nuclear power. In response to the Fukushima Daiichi disaster, hundreds of protesters in Madrid, Spain, also rallied for an immediate shutdown of Spain's nuclear plants. "We appreciate the efforts of the Japanese officials and dedicated workers for your efforts to restore safety to the region, as well as the citizens in both Japan and abroad, for your unified voice of concern for the welfare of people and the environment. May radiation and related dangers soon be eliminated through humanity's more benevolent stewardship of the ecosphere."